Hello students, in this class we are going to discuss about viewing data in the table. What it mean viewing data in the table? Nothing but after creating a table, after inserting some records nothing but the values which we are going to insert into a table, we have to view that one, all those datas which are there in our table. We have to view, either it may be for report purpose or it may be for correction purpose or to gain some information and all. For all those needs, we need to view the data. So that one is nothing but viewing data in the table. So for this one, so we know that one, to create a table, we have create table command. To insert some records, we have a insert into command also. In a previous sessions, we have discussed like we can insert a values into a table, what are the different variations in that one and all. So after inserting a record, we have to view. To view, we are going to use a keyword in SQL, nothing but select, select command is used to retrieve rows selected from one or more table. So here we have the word like one or more table, nothing but we can select some of the rows from multiple tables and we can generate our reports. That one is also possible in our SQL statement. So while we are working with in one table, we can extract the data from one table. So if you are working with the multiple tables, in that particular time we need to extract some records from a multiple tables. So the way how we can view, or the different needs of data, how we have to view, so depending upon that one we are classified entire way of viewing a data into main two categories. First one, all rows and all columns. Second one, filtering table data. So in our first one we will discuss all rows and all columns, nothing but entire details, entire which and all rows and which and all columns are there in our table, we have to view that one. In a second one, in a second filtering the table data. Filtering the table, in that one we have a first option like a selected columns and all rows. So we know that one, in our table many number of columns and any number of rows we can insert into a table. So in that particular time, so in we may face any situation, we need some of the columns only, then entire records and all the students or entire entities details we have to display. In that particular time we have to go for the first category of filtering a data, selected columns and all rows. In a second category we have selected rows and all columns, nothing but we don't want entire rows from a table, nothing but entire records we don't want to display. Depending upon some conditions we have to display the records, but we need entire column. If we in our table, if we have 10 number of rows and 10 number of columns, all the 10 columns we have to display. Third one, selected column and selected row. So here we have to make a choose which and all columns we have to display, which and all rows we have to display. So these detail, these types we will discuss in detail. First we will see the first one, all rows and all columns. So all rows and all columns in the sense entire table details, entire table columns and rows we need to display. So for that one what we have to do, so we have to follow some syntax. So for a select statement we have a syntax, for to view our data we are going to use a select command. The syntax as follows, as in displayed in our screen. So select, after that one we need to write column name 1 to column name n from table name. If you want to give a explanation for this one syntax, so select is a keyword. After that one, between select and from we need to specify which and all columns we need to display. So here all the columns we need to display, that's why we need to specify entire column names. Suppose in our table we have 5 number of columns, we need to specify 5 column names, then each one will be separated by comma. After specifying the column names, we need to specify from, that one is a keyword. After that one, table name. Table name is the from which table we have to view the data, all those table names we have to specify. Either it may be a one table, if we are working with the multiple tables, in the sense we need to specify the names of all those tables. So here we have a better example, simple one example, just follow that one. So I am taking one example of student table. So in this particular table I am maintaining the details like student number, student name, gender, class and marks. So here we are maintaining the five records, nothing but five student entities. We are student entities information we are going to enter into a student table. After inserting, if I want to view all the tables, rows and columns, in the sense, according to the syntax, what I have to do at the beginning, I have to write select. After writing a select keyword, I have to specify which one and all column names. Here we are there in a all column category, so we have to write each and every column names like same as it is there in our student table structure. So in a student table structure, which and how we have given our names for those columns, same names we have to give. So in a student table, for a first column is mine is nothing but student number, S number, comma, S name, third one is a gender, fourth one is a class, and marks is the fifth one. Nothing but I am specifying each and every columns which and all are there in my table. After specifying the column, so each and every column names we should be separated by comma as a delimiter. We are going to use a comma as a delimiter. After specifying the column names, we need to use a keyword from. Nothing but these columns from which table we have to select. That's why from. After specifying the from, we need to specify from which table. So according to the syntax, student becomes a table name. At the end, we need to specify the semicolon to identify we are there in the end of the query. So also we can write it as a, so this is the one way to write a query. So nothing but after select, all the columns names we have to specify. Or one more way also we can write a select command. That one is nothing but, so select, instead of specifying each and every column names, we can specify only, if we put star, it represent entire column names we have to, or entire columns we have to select from that specified table. So to view all rows and all columns from a table, we can follow the two syntax. First one, specifying entire column names. Second one, instead of specifying entire column names, just put a star. So it comes to use when we have a 50-60 number of columns in our table, in the sense, or large number of column names, in the sense, in that particular time we can view. So after executing, what it will happen, so entire rows and columns will be displayed in our table. So that one is about viewing all the rows and all the columns in our table. So filtering our table data, that one we are going to discuss in a next part of a video. Thank you.